Are people using the word alcoholic as a way to divert the attention away from their own alcohol issues? I'm Kevin O'Hara for AlcoholMastery.com, and today I just wanted to look at this thing. Why do a lot of people use the term alcoholic? Why do we use it as a society to isolate one portion of people from everyone else, right? You know, we have normal drinkers and then we have alcoholics or problem drinkers. You know, I've been accused of this a lot of times, that I'm not an alcoholic, and I was never an alcoholic. I was a problem drinker. So where do those kind of differentiations come from? Huh? You know, why do we see these kind of things? So for me, you have to look at the relationship between alcohol and other drugs, right? Even when you look at cigarettes, right? Alcohol and cigarettes, right? Another legal drug. You don't get this thing, you know, you don't get this differentiation. You know, you don't get normal smokers and problem smokers. I'm going to adjust this camera a little bit. That's it. Hurt my arm. Right. Yeah, you don't get, there's no differentiation between normal smokers and problem smokers. You might get sort of people sort of contrast themselves if they're a smoker and go, well, you know, I'm only a one-a-day smoker, or I'm a 10-a-day smoker, I'm only a light smoker and they're a heavy smoker. I'm a pack-a-day and they're a three-pack-a-day, you know. But at the end of the day, everyone knows that smoking is bad for them. They didn't always know that. This wasn't always the case, but they do now. So that's the only definition, that's the only comparison that I can see between those two things. With any other drugs, with all the illegal drugs, you would never hear that. Never hear such a thing, excuse me, as a normal heroin user and a heroinaholic. What would you call that? You know, there just is no word for that. There's just a drug user or a non-drug user. You know, that's the only, different. There might be amongst that community, there might be a person who goes, well, you know, I take it for social occasions to be sociable. Do they do that? Maybe cocaine. They say, well, I'm a social cocaine user, and this guy's he's completely addicted to it. You know, he takes it all the time. But in the general public, outside of that, you know, there's no definition. Is there a comparison? You know, do people who don't drink, do they see that kind of comparison, or is it just amongst the drinkers? And that's where I think the issue lies, is because I think it is just between the drinkers. And I think that because the drinkers make up such a massive proportion of society, you know, not only between the amount of people that are drinking alcohol, but these people are positioned in every walk of life. You know, these drinkers are, you know, they're doctors, they're nurses, they're school teachers, they're lawyers, they're judges, they're police men, they're police chiefs, they're politicians. These are the people that make the rules. These are the people that set the standards. These are the people that tell us, all the plebs, the plebs, the plebeians, the gutter folk, what the rules are and what is normal in society. These are the people that do all that. So we're brought up with this in our lives. So, you know, I just made me think a little bit about it, that's all. You know, you get a lot of people who say, well, you know, differentiate themselves by saying, well, I enjoy my glass of wine in the evening, and I drink to relax, or I drink to socialize, or I drink for whatever, you know, whatever your X marks the spot, right? You get people who say, well, you know, he's an alcoholic, he's a thing because he does this or he does that. You get people who go, well, I drink only the best quality of wine. I'm a wine connoisseur, or I'm a beer connoisseur. I mean, I was shocked at the amount of beers that are in the world. If you go to England and you see that there's so many different microbreweries and just different tastes for ale. You know, you go into one pub and they'll have all different ales and beers, and you know, one saying, well, you know, my beer is made from this process, and the other one saying, well, yeah, my beer has got honey in it, or my beer smells like Christmas cake. In Ireland, you've got a few beers, you know, you've four or five beers that are regularly served across the counter, so there's no differentiation between that, you know. I remember once sat at a bar with a guy, friend of mine, and this American, we started talking to this American, and he was talking to us about Ireland and, you know, just different stuff. And then he said, I love this stuff. I'm not going to do the American accent because I know there's a lot of American viewers and I'm not going to butcher it, right? So he was saying that he loved this particular type of scotch, and he said it was just beautiful. You know, it was pure, it was, I can't even remember what the exact terms that he was coming out with, but he was bigging it up anyway, you know. He was giving it some large, you know. He had a lot of different verbs that he was using about this whiskey. So he ordered one of these things, and it was €25 for a single shot, right? And he got the shot. And then he put coke in it. And it was just like, all the words that he had said were just went down the toilet. You know, everything that he said about this whiskey, it was, I mean, and this was at a time when I didn't know what I was doing to myself. I didn't understand. This is a real rambly video, isn't it? This was at a time when I didn't understand what I was doing to myself. So, you know, we were just laughing at the stupidity of it. And even then we could see the stupidity. But there's, you know, I'm just saying that there's those types of differentiations, right? And it's mostly because, it's mostly in the alcohol world, because people, there's so many people that drink, they're everywhere. And they're making up their own rules as they go along to excuse what they're doing to themselves, you know. And as I said, you know, in the old days, people lived in villages, and if you had an alcohol problem in a village, everybody would find out about it sooner or later, you know, and probably sooner, because you couldn't hide things then, you know. You know, everything was bought in the one store, so you probably only have one pub or whatever, you know. And closed communities are going to find out about these problems very soon. And in the modern world, these things aren't uncovered as quickly, if ever. You know, you can hide an alcohol problem or a drug problem for a long, long time until there is actual physical, until you're showing the physical consequences of what you've been doing to yourself, right? You know, if you live over the other side of the town from all your mates and your social life and your job and, you know, what you do as a normal part of your life, you could live around the corner and people wouldn't know. You know, you go and buy your booze somewhere else, you know, you don't drink near where you live. The possibilities for doing that now are massive, so you can have a big problem without either people knowing that you've got it to help you, or to hinder your progress through life, you know, to start causing problems for you. So I suspect that there are a lot of people who know that what they're drinking is heavy. Nobody can possibly be unaware of the safe amount of drink. Now I'm going to do a video about this as well, because new research has been done, or just a new look at the old research, and this has just debunked a lot of the old crap about alcohol being good for you. But I'm saying nobody knows the nobody can tell me that they don't know what the safe limits of alcohol drinking are. So, you know, there's a lot of people who will sit behind closed doors and sip away in a bottle of wine and have no problem drinking a bottle of wine, or four or five cans of beer in a night and see no problem with it, and hide from the fact. They'll hide from themselves, they'll hide it from other people because nobody is contradicting them. You know, when a gang of people go out and they're together for the night and nobody's counting the beers, everyone's being an accomplice for each other. So I'm just saying that it's a big hypocrisy. I think that when you're a drinker, that's when you're an alcoholic. I think if you drink regularly, and you drink regularly over the amount that you're supposed to drink, which apparently is a lot less than what you are currently told that you can drink. But we'll dig about that into in another video. Yeah. Anyway, I'm going to close this off for now. And leave a comment below. Let me know what you think, as normal. Until next time, I'm Kevin O'Hara for Alcohol Mastery. Onwards and upwards. Good luck.